A spooky evening to you. I'm Twink Macaraig, brewing a potion to keep you tuned in to our horror stories from the elections, the Supreme Court, and the boxing arena.
Good evening, I'm Sister Gang, and I come from the Convent of the Twisted Sisters. Join me in saying a prayer for our departed, including the late psychic Octopus.
And I'm Princess Fiona, Nadia Trinidad. Join us tonight as we talk to the man courting death by drawing the ire of the Catholic Church. It's Witching Hour. Welcome to the Halloween episode of The Brew.
My name is Gang. How are you, Princess?
I'm good. I'm good without the headpiece.
Is that your husband?
Yeah,
that's awful.
I turn into this at night. So.
Oh, okay.
Good evening. Trick or treat.
Trick or treat. Yeah, well, I am appropriately dressed. This, of course, being the brew, I have been crowned the Queen BREWhaha for tonight.
And Twink came as she is. Come as you are. See, come as you are, and I'm a nun. Yeah. Actually, I am a nun because this has always been my mom's fantasy. She always watches this Eternal World Whatever channel, and she just always wanted to see me as a nun. So I thought I'd indulge my mother and dress up as a nun tonight.
I wanted
I like
to be
my
a
fan,
princess
though. You like my fan?
Until they told me I'd be Princess Fiona.
That's
now
tricky.
Can I be a nun?
Yeah, that's Princess Fiona yan. But anyway, welcome to The Brew. This is our Halloween night, and we have lots of scary stories to tell you.
Let's check out the horror stories in The BREWhaha. The suspect in the bar exam blast finally surfaces a month after the horror in Taft, Manila. But even before officials could begin questioning Anthony Nepomuceno, his fraternity brother, Vice President Jejomar Binay, already gave a verdict. Now the BREWhaha is, should the country's second highest official comment about a case under investigation?
Eh, malungkot yung siya na mapagbintangan. Pero batay sa aming pagtatanong, agi sa kanya, palagay ko, hindi, unang-una, walang kasalanan to.
But shouldn't the courts look at the pieces of evidence and not at the assertions made by the second highest official of the country?
That's even worse than trial by media. You know the term trial by media, where media will cover a case under investigation and immediately give a slant. Mm-hmm. He's the vice president. I think that's even worse.
I do believe, though, that he is quite aware that he has no... there is no value actually to anything that he says court-wise. But the reason I think he felt he had to say that, mind you, remember that he played a very special role. It was because of him that the suspect was convinced to come out and turn himself in. So how do you, I mean, can you imagine him therefore after having talked to this guy to there after say, he's possibly guilty.
But the priority is justice.
But I don't think he affects justice in this case. I think all he did was he sealed a bond that he had developed with this person that he had convinced.
Did he just reiterate the innocent until proven guilty thing? If
yes,
that's
he
all
did.
He did, it then was, I'm cool
it
with
was
it.
Always, but, and that's another thing that we, of course, don't show in the clip, that little snippet that we use was actually part of a bigger thing where, of course, he says he must be subjected to due process. Of course, he will face the full judicial system, etc., etc.
But isn't it bad enough that our justice system finds itself in its present state? And having the vice president say something like this that might influence the court's decision.
I mean, there's a premise because of malakasan. So if
this is the Philippines,
if Vice President Binay is malakas to someone, then there might be an influence on that.
I'm just saying, it's I don't think it helps things. It just might aggravate the situation.
It's just so funny talking to a princess and a witch. It's just so new to me. From horror in the bar exams. Well, our law and our justice system is crazy. Lots of ghost stories. Let's move on to ghost writers. More people support the UP law professors in their battle against the Supreme Court. The UP law faculty criticizes the court's decision to clear Associate Justice Mariana del Castillo of plagiarism. But the court blames the error on the researcher's inadvertence and even Microsoft Word.
The only explanation there would be really, you know, a plain inadvertence. And that can really happen, considering how the researchers conduct research. No? Yes, we're talking about plagiarism. No? And plagiarism, it has been defined that there must be intent.
It will actually endanger the practice within the academe of persons who are going after plagiarists. Because
exactly.
Now, for example, I will submit a paper, and a formal academic paper, I will copy portions from some other person's work without attributing it, without putting any quotation marks. And then when I'm caught, I will simply say, well, you know, it was an accident. It was the fault of Microsoft Word. Was not attributed was because Microsoft Word did not have an alarm that would go off if something was not, attributed correctly.
Microsoft should just come up with software that comes with people to tell you what you're typing. Hey, that's plagiarism. No, why blame the software? I think that's crazy. Anyway, what do you think, Twink?
Well, it's actually a very, I think, dark point for the Supreme Court. This is truly shameful what they've done with regard to this particular incident, and I wonder whether it might actually lead to some sort of a crisis, whereby they just seem so clearly in the wrong in this case. Mm-hmm. And I don't know how the people can just stand by.
I don't know how they don't see that. Uh-huh. I mean, it's clearly...
It's plagiarism.
Ugly,
it's
no way.
Passing off somebody's work as yours. And even if it was an honest mistake, the evidence on paper would show that you tried to pull something like that.
I feel awful for the researcher, though. I don't know.
Somebody told me, what's with Ateneans? I was being mocked for, because apparently...
the recent MVP speech plagiarism too. Mm-hmm. That was pretty clear as well. So I'm thinking, wow, grabe yung Supreme Court. What do you think they should do? Should they just say, all right, yes?
I don't think they can undo it, though. The damage is done. They have refused to... compel one of their own to face the consequences for his acts. They have circled the wagons around the poor UP law faculty that had just, I think, stated the obvious. How can they back down? How can they back down at this point? But it's all leading up to a really horrible head, I believe.
But what will we tell our children? I mean, if I'm a student, I can just...
Yeah,
I can just write a paper that you wrote, gang, and say that
I just keep quoting intelligent people and I'll claim the statements as mine. This veil is awful, sorry.
But can I say, though, that I think the logical conclusion to this is that they will be impeached. Or people will call for, and this of course would be unprecedented in the entire history of the world.
And what is
the
honorable thing to do? What's the honorable thing to do? If
in
you
this
are
country?
Maidas Marquez.
In this country?
Well, it would not be for Maidas Marquez, I think, to decide.
To
really,
honor.
He's just
no,
he's just a spokesman. Anyway,
cool.
There are many horrors.